AK, can you hear me, buddy?
I hear you, Michael.
170.5, the official weight for Gilbert Durinho Burns.
Thank you, Gilbert. Gilbert, this way.
170.5 for Gilbert Burns.
Durinho.
And UFC, what the? Oh, right. Okay, right. Yes. Okay.
All right, next athlete to the scale coming up on his 20th UFC appearance here Saturday night, 15th ranked middleweight contender, Brad Tavares.
Straight ahead, Brad.
184.5, the official weight for Brad Tavares.
Thank you, Brad.
This way, Brad.
One 184.5 for Brad Tavares, as John Anik just noted, making UFC appearance number 20. That coming off of the old fighters. I mean, a nice, very nice career for himself. So apologies for the technical difficulties, guys. I believe we had Rafael Dos Anjos weigh in. Looks like he weighed in at 156. In case we missed it, he is apparently going to be a potential replacement should something happen to Saturday's lightweight main event. So RDA, you guys probably saw this reported earlier in the week. RDA was here, he was cutting weight, and now he has mid weight. So we do have a backup for Saturday's main event. Fingers crossed, should anything happen to it. And of course, hopefully RDA is being compensated for his for the time that he's putting in here. But thank you everyone for joining us. Again, apologies for any technical difficulties that we've had. It is out of our control. There's mercy of the internet on site, but thank you everyone for watching. We'll keep anything we miss, guys. We're gonna keep on the screen. Don't worry about it. You will be caught up. Nobody has missed weight yet, sooner rather than later.
There you go.
Mike, have you seen an official announcement? Have you heard or seen any official announcement about the RDA backup thing? I know we've reported it, everyone's reported it. Did you see the UFC mention it yet?
No, but they typically don't. Remember?
That's right. That was so. We were all like, why are they allowing the stranger to get up on the scale? This seems not legal. And we're like, oh, it's a replacement fight, potential replacement fight. Just letting people know on Twitter what is up with RDA coming in. Placement. So again, as you said, guys, no finger crossed. I don't mean jinx anything. I don't believe that sort of thing. Yet. And again, we'll have our graphic up on every now and then, guys, so you can see what's going on. But it's been a busy, wild week as it is. Mike, can you hear me? I just make sure we can still hear each other.
Yes, I can hear you. You're coming in and out, but again, just to let the people know, new with us, okay. This is UFC related, folks.
I'm gonna send them a message right now.
Yeah, we have 11 left.
I'm just said there's 11 fighters remaining. Of course, Conor McGregor is one of them.
I'm surprised
Stephen
we're getting
Wonderboy Thompson is one of them. In fact, I don't.
I always look for Merriman.
I don't know if Casey can hear me, but I know. I don't want to get too excited, and I don't want to say the magic pill until there some of our matchups are. Again, I don't want to say the word yet. I see two, three.
Okay.
We have three matchups.
There's Connor.
That we could potentially play music for.
Two-division UFC champion, the iconic.
Here comes Connor.
Connor McGregor. The official weight, 156 pounds for Conor McGregor.
Thank you, Conor.
Your main event for UFC 264.
It does Poirier. Built around both of them, John Anik. Dustin Poirier successfully made weight earlier. So, Casey, I don't know if you can hear me. I don't know if we can play the music now. That's fine. But I will just say, people, imagine it in your head, because the main event is now official. So we are good. We're just waiting now for the main event and a few other main card bouts. Ah, there we go. Well done, Mike. Even better.
Thank you.
I'm just sorry, guys. Some info here. That was fantastic. All right. So the trilogy is official. No drama there. Again, when it comes to these guys, oh, we got a good look at Connor here. He's talking. He is talking. No surprise. We will see more of these gentlemen later. Of course, this is a pay-per-view, so there will be.
To the scale, the other half of the co-main event in the UFC's welterweight division, former two-time world title challenger and number four in the world at present, Stephen Wonderboy Thompson.
Here comes one half of the co-main event.
170
and a half. Oh, Wonderboy.
170 and a half, the official weight for Stephen Thompson.
Thank you, Stephen.
Stephen Thompson. Big.
All right, next fight
title
to
implications.
The UFC flyweight division,
there.
Former world title challenger, number
particularly
four.
Particularly if Wonderboy
Jennifer
wins, I think most
Maya.
People. Here comes Jennifer Mo. I think most people are. If Gilbert Burns wins, he probably will not be getting another shot at Kamaru Usman anytime soon. Line with alongside Colby Covington.
And a half.
The official weight 125 and a half for Jennifer Maya.
Thank you, Jennifer.
So that is also official. No one has missed weight, including headliners Conor McGregor and Dustin Poirier. And co-headliners Gilbert Burns and Stephen Wonderboy Thompson.
Fighter to the scale, one of the top contenders in the UFC women's bantamweight division, set to compete live on pay-per-view tomorrow, Irene Aldana.
Irene Aldana, number four.
It was
139.5. That's big 9.5 for Irene Aldana. If you guys couldn't hear John, you probably hear John Anik better than me right now. 139.5. That's 3.5 over the bantamweight limit obviously very doubtful that she will make a second attempt. I don't know if she could cut 3.5 pounds. So it looks like
heavyweight division part of your pay-per-view main card, Ty Bam Bam Tuivasa.
And here comes our first of two heavyweights, Ty Tuivasa.
The official weight, 263 pounds for Ty Tuivasa.
Thank you, Ty.
Let's go. Ty is working the
exit. 263 for Ty Tuivasa.
What? It's full? Oh, yeah. No, I know. Maybe since you didn't turn it off because of the audio. Wait, what? Oh, because the blower. The blower was so we told us that you should need to just make sure.
Come on in, I'm getting the
straight over to the ceremonies afterwards, because you have to do other ceremonies. You don't, all this equipment stays triple stuff.
Yes.
From yesterday, right? Yeah. Essentially.
Yeah, it's all talk stuff.
Yeah. Will you be, where will you be? Will you be on the back platform again? Such a long throw. For you guys, how do you, dude, it's crazy.
It's end of my life.
Yeah.
I wasn't even touching it.
Yeah. No.
30 rows of...
Okay.
It didn't used to be that far, just, right?
No.
Okay.
No, only one who's done the super big one, but that was exceptional.
Yeah, it's like a 600.
I think it was up to the idea for something.
Yeah.
Bigger rather than
bigger.
Yeah.
Fighting
the
bullets,
splitting the difference.
That makes sense, yeah.
No, Fox should never be at the end of the match. Not for a broadcast shot.
Yeah.
But when you're shooting a bird in a net.
Oh, they need to build.
That one should never be.
For the main shot, yeah.
Well, they should just put your platform in the halfway. Right? They should have just moved your platform in the middle.
Yeah. But every other event, the best is the are better.
Yeah.
Around us, yeah,
right.
Just is what it is. We've got a big screen.
Right.
So we do every other event.
Yeah.
But this roller coaster has its own.
Or continue. Over puck action from the season.
I think.
Send it in, man. Dude, those things. What a joke. It's all reaction.
Oh, of course.
They wanted to remove all the photo holes when that incident happened. So you guys understand that they can do that. They get slashed. Look like the thing gets slashed. Yeah. It's almost even worse to trap it, because if you try to trap it and it hangs right in there, then you
can trap it. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah. It should be less. Less is more. Leave it how it was. But whatever.
Oh, Kenny.
Why they didn't remove the footage? Because then your images are kind of useless. It's not the same as the video.
No.
It completely loses quality. I wouldn't mind. It'd be a lot easier. It'd be different. It's just not the impact. I would prefer it, but I don't like being wedged in like 2 square feet of like. Sucks. Yeah. Oh, they're
cheap. Every time the eyes put in your eyes,
everybody
door opens, everybody at the back of the door.
Oh my God.
And in the dead song, you have to go to the back of the
door.
Could it be like T-Mobile where they build a different store like for other purposes?
It's just our
restaurant. Yeah.
just want to see if you guys can hear. Give me a happy birthday in the comments if you guys, in the YouTube comments, if you guys can hear me. But I'll proceed as if you can. We have the graphic on screen there. You guys can see. Mike, if you can hear, I think you can might be able to join us as well. But for now, if it's just me, let's give you guys a little rundown of the weigh-in results so far. As you can see at the top of the card, our headliners for their trilogy bout, Dustin Poirier and Conor McGregor successfully made the lightweight limit, both using the 1 pound allowance, coming in at 156. Thank you guys. Thank you for the comments. Gilbert Burns, Stephen Thompson, welterweight contenders in the co-main event, also successfully made weight, both weighing in at 170.5 pounds. Tai Tuivasa, heavyweight, 263. We're still waiting for his opponent, Greg Hardy. Also on the main card, Aline Aldana, Yana Kuniskaya, scheduled to meet at bantamweight. Kuniskaya successfully made it, 134.5. Aline Aldana, unfortunately, well over. You can see the red numbers of shame there. 139.5, 3.5 pounds over the limit. Again, we haven't heard word yet. We assume she will not be making her attempt to cut. And we're just waiting here. Will it proceed as a catch weight? And how much of Irene Aldana's purse will she forfeit? I would guess 30%. And leading off the main card, Sean O'Malley, 135.5, facing late notice replacement Chris Moutinho at 135, who came in at 135. Moutinho stepping in as replacement for Luis Smolka. Closing out the ESPN preliminaries, Max Griffin and Carlos Condit. Griffin at 170.5. We have someone coming up.
In the UFC's featherweight division, the undefeated Ilya Topuria.
Ilya Topuria coming up next.
Half, the official weight for Ilya Topuria.
Thank you, sir.
145.5 for Ilya Topuria. His opponent, Ryan Hall, made weight successfully earlier at 145, so that fight's official. Topuria versus Hall. So, continue on, guys. So, as I said, Max Griffin made weight 170.5 for this fight with Carlos Condit. We're still waiting for Ms. Condit to show up. Nico Price, 169.5 for his fight with Michelle Pereira. We're still waiting on Pereira. And it came in at 145.5 to face Ryan Hall, who weighed in at 145. Then we have three more official fights. Middleweights Dricus du Plessis at 185.5 in a middleweight bout against Trevin Giles, also 185.5. Then we have flyweights Jennifer Maia and Jessica Ai, both successfully making weight at 125.5. And a middleweight encounter between Omari at 105 and Brad Tavares at 184.5. Tavares making UFC appearance number 20. Congratulations to him. Zalgas Zumagulov, 125.5 for his flyweight bout with Jerome Rivera. We're still waiting on Jerome. And Hu Yaozong at 185. Irms opener against Alan Amadovsky, who we are still waiting on. So as you can see, guys, it certainly has been somewhat eventful because we've had, anytime you have Poirier McGregor, certainly it is something to talk about. But we also had one miss so far, guys, one miss with Irene Aldana, and the status of that bout is still pending. So we could be here for a bit, guys, because like I said, we have another heavyweight to wait for, and in Greg Hardy. And as we know, heavyweights do tend to take their time.
All right, next letter to the scale in the UFC's middleweight division. Alan Amadovsky.
Straight ahead. 186,
the official weight for Alan Amadovsky.
Thank you.
186 for Alan Up. Hu Yaozong is now official. So there we go, guys. Another one in the books. Fingers crossed for all these fighters. People, we are not anywhere near in the clear yet There's plenty of time. Certainly, we have almost 90 minutes remaining. So let's hope no other mishaps. But again, we have, you know, we've got some veterans on here. Michelle Pejeda, who has, and who else are we? All right, Craig Hardy, Carlos Condit, Michelle Pejeda. Okay, and Jerome Rivera. Jerome Rivera. This will be a second fight in the UFC at flyweight, so we'll see. He's probably got that figured out. And Amandowski just came in, so we're only waiting on four names. Four names left, guys. Thank you guys, by the way, for sticking around. I know we've had some technical issues, but again, this is when you've got an event where half of, feels like the entire MMA media is there, plus miscellaneous characters who, if you watched the UFC 264 press conference on Thursday, you probably saw some faces that you didn't recognize, probably some new people, probably a gentleman in a pink suit who who I believe is a South Florida radio host who had the audacity to confront Conor McGregor and present him with the sort of the reality of his MMA record. But that was certainly one of the notable confrontations that we saw at the UFC 264 press conference. Not to mention, of course, the heat between Poirier and McGregor. So guys, while we wait for the next one, please just who do you think won that press conference? Go ahead, say it in the comments. Just type Poirier or McGregor or Notorious or Diamond, or do a diamond emoji. You know, I'll know who you guys are talking about. Give us some idea here of who you thought came out on top. I will not, if you didn't see our reaction show, I will not give my opinion. I don't want to bias. I don't want to influence your select. So just let us know who won. Who won on Thursday? We had McGregor bringing, you know, his usual bluster. He had a lot. He was energetic. He was foul mouthed. He was very aggressive. He had a lot of talking points. Jackson Bass chiming in. We all lost. Oh, that's well, that is not that's not encouraging. So Jackson Bass, not a fan of the press conference. We have Sky the Sports Guy coming in with a diamond. Samuel Spencer agrees. We've got a lot of Dustins. MDSL says El Diamante. So Dustin and Greg M5021 also saying. Oh, so we got some real talk from Saluska fan who says Dana White won. He always wins. Ugh. So. And we have people saying McGregor was reaching. Yeah, I mean, look, McGregor, like I said, he talked a lot. I don't know how the reaction show went. I sort of said, if you're a McGregor fan, you're probably pretty happy with what you saw. I don't know. I don't speak for all McGregor fans. I don't speak for all Poirier fans, but I think McGregor fans probably got what they wanted. The crowd, according to Jose Youngs, the crowd was just absolutely on fire for Conor McGregor. So for those of us watching at home, we might think like, oh, his act is getting a little played out, but the people in Vegas are definitely feeling that Conor McGregor energy. Let's see some more comments here. Troy is filming says Dustin was calm, cool, and collected. Conor was trying to hype himself up into the old Conor, and it felt kind of flat. Okay. Fong Nguyen says Conor win. Mixed Perfection also with a we all lost. It was pretty cringy. Angela Montgomery says Dustin won. Conor seemed like he was forcing things. He didn't have his normal flow. I can agree with that. I do think. Again, if people, you know, you guys can watch that. We have the footage, of course, of that press conference on MMA Fighting's YouTube channel. I do think that McGregor was just throwing a lot of stuff out there and not even waiting to see like if it stuck, just throwing it out and knowing that the crowd would eat it up. Which again, in fairness, they did. The crowd, as usual, was hanging on Conor's every word. Trivi8 says Conor was reaching and stale. So I do seem to see also the sentiment that yes, maybe his act has worn a little. I think if he wins, I think we'll see a lot of people sort of enjoying some of his talk again. All right, we got one from The Split Decision who says, I don't know if he's a fan of either guy. Con Man McNuggets won the press conference because Dustin stumbled over most of his lines. Even his pre-written lines, he was bobbling. Scott McCrae, what's up, Scott? Regular viewer. It all felt kind of forced, AK. So it seems like the talk is played out between them. Yeah, I can agree with that. I think we just want to see these two gentlemen. When you fought three times, and there is still some heat behind it, I do think we're all kind of interested in seeing them fight again. I'm not sure what can be said to to really change, to really make us want to watch it more. So doesn't sound like people bought into it. Joshua Carey says Connor seemed angry for the wrong reason. He seemed angry for the wrong reason. Terrence Lover says Connor wasn't himself. Pardon my language here, folks. This is Terrence Lever speaking. Connor wasn't himself. I think he doesn't go balls to the wall like he used to. People bring his legal troubles. I think some of I don't know if any of his opponents have really made direct kind of inferences to how that's gone. If I'm forgetting completely, obviously, guys, call me out. But it does seem like he hasn't left himself open to it. But Leviathan Stockmeyer, listen to this, bro. Please, Connor was so tryhard. Kid sounded like an angry boy on Xbox losing his kill streak. What a joke. That is quite a accusation to lay out, because let me tell you something. When those Xbox players lose their kill streaks, I mean, they get really furious. It did kind of feel like that, though. Mike L asking again, who was that guy in the pink jacket? His name escapes me. I apologize. He is a South Florida radio personality, I think, a reporter personality. I believe he was traveling with some of the South Florida fighters. I know he was there with Dean Thomas and I think Amanda Nunez and some of them. So he's not hard to find, guys. Use whatever social media you use, like a pink jacket guy. He's replied to a lot of comments about him, so he's out there. Wade Duell says Connor only cares to do boxing. He has forgotten that this is MMA. The talk has played out. It felt forced. I'm so tired of Connor and his bullcrap. Oh my goodness. Connor has many regrets. Sluska fan is asking, any heavyweight ever missed weight? Funny you ask that, Sluska fan. So Greg is one of the names we are waiting for. And people remember he did come in a pound heavy, or I don't remember if it was most recent, but I think it was either his most recent fight or the before that. He did have extra time to cut weight, so he did come down on his initial try. Greg Hardy, yes, somehow found a way to miss the heavyweight limit. So that doesn't happen very often. And again, technically he did not miss it. That's if he did make it on the second try, but that's the closest he comes. So Greg Hardy drama can always seems to follow this guy around. Imp, a comment Imp on YouTube says, Connor fans are trying to convince themselves that Dustin's social awkwardness was calling in El Diamante's head. Oh, I see. So again, for anyone who happened to miss the press conference, Poirier was mostly calm and collected and kind of quiet. He picked his shots when responding. And, you know, if you're a Connor fan, you probably said, oh, he's intimidated. You know, he's intimidated. That's why he's not responding. Tyler David predicts that Connor loses, retires, and waits for anyone to care about Diaz 3, the Diaz trilogy. I that's a little harsh. I think that Diaz trilogy heat will always be there. I think retirement talk is realistic, if only because the man has made so much money. I don't know why he would need to fight. Guys, if you want me to talk about anything else, by the way, besides the press conference, thank you. Oh, thank you guys for all your comments and all your input. I know I solicited the question. Thank you guys for chiming in on that. Please feel free. Feel free. We can talk about anything else from the card. We've got a lot of time here as we wait for our last four names: Greg Hardy, Carlos Condit, Michelle Pereira, and Jerome Rivera. So just four names to wait for. But please ask questions. A lot of storylines to talk about going into UFC 264. Pretty good looking card. Al Mack going as far as to say is that press conference tarnished his legacy. Al Mack, I assume you're referring to McGregor. I'm not sure. You could be referring to Poirier. But... One second here, guys. Just gathering these thoughts here. Floor is yours, guys. Again, for anyone just tuning in now, or who's been sticking with us, apologize for any technical difficulties we had earlier. We have our top guys in the building. We've got Jose Young's on site. We've got EKC Lydon on site. They are keeping this together. It's very difficult imagine the massive amount of this every Conor McGregor fight gets, and we're all kind of, you know, sharing the same space, sharing the same Wi-Fi and everything. So thank you everyone who's stuck around. Let me see. You guys are coming in good with the comments. Al Mack, where's Casey? We need Casey's there. Casey's in Las Vegas. If you're in Las Vegas, go say hi to Casey. Damian Brooks wants to know, AK, how many times do you celebrate your birthday in a year? Personally, none. I do not celebrate my birthday at all. But the good crew at MMA Fighting and you guys in the comments pretty much rate it every day. So 365, 364 in a leap year? Angela Montgomery wants to know, did Aldana look like she was hurting on the scale? You know what, Angela, I'll be honest, I'm here. She didn't look like she was hurting. I do feel like because she came in so far over, she may have cut her weight cut short, as it were. She may have stopped her attempt earlier, may have already, I don't want to say already begun rehydrating, because she might have been even more over, but I have a feeling that they knew well ahead of the weigh in that she wasn't going to make it. So she didn't look like, she didn't look drained, I didn't think. But we'll do a preview show later. I'm sure that can come up if you want to. Jose can chime in on that. Jose is there and Casey is there. They've got a better look at the situation. Badoof 12, Greg Hardy cut if he loses. I would hope so. I say this, by the way, I say this now, let me announce my bias. This is a media member bias. I'm not a fan of Greg Hardy. Obviously, there's personal reasons. I'm sure you guys all know his history. I'm not a fan of that stuff. I don't think he's a particularly good fighter. So anything I say here, take this with a grain of salt. But I do think, I would think he should be. I sincerely doubt it. I think the UFC still sees potential in him. I think they still see that there's some crossover appeal because of his career as an NFL player. And he's a heavyweight. He's a heavyweight that's younger than, I believe he's younger than 30 years. How old is this guy? I'm sorry, guys. Let me check. Oh, he's 32. But either way, he's still, fresh in MMA. So I don't think, unless he somehow embarrasses himself in this performance, I think even if he gets knocked out, I think they still give him another chance. If he does some weirdness during the fight and maybe puts on a bad fight, maybe loses like a listless three-round decision, then I think you might give him, you might see him get cut. But otherwise, I'm pretty sure he gets another chance. Pretty sure he gets another chance. CSS 172, any idea who is the ref for the main event? Yes, veteran referee, Herb Dean. I always say Herb, I'm sorry. Veteran referee, Herb Dean, will be overseeing the main event. People I know Herb has had his mishaps, so I understand the probably some consternation over hearing that news, but he is a veteran, he's done a lot of main events. Clearly the commissions trust him, this is why he keeps getting these assignments, make of that what you will. Let's see what else we got here. Miguel Angel Perez says, who's a fighter who is flying under the radar, a dark horse to bet on? I will not give gambling advice. My only gambling advice is never to gamble. So anything I tell you guys is like who's who thinks going to win a fight, what to look for in the matchups, things like that. It is strictly from a speculative kind of have fun entertainment perspective. I'd say do not bet on MMA. I don't think you should bet on sports, but look, I'm not going to stop you either. Flying under the radar, I think Zalgas Zumagulov could have a really nice showing. No disrespect to Jerome Rivera, but he has struggled a little bit in the UFC. I do think Zumagulov, who's on a nice win streak, I do think he can. I'm mixing Zumagulov with David Dvorak. Both guys are very much in need of a win. But I do like Zumagulov, actually. I do like the stop him before the UFC. And I think he just needs to get on track with a win here. So I'll call him a little bit of a sleeper. My apologies, though. I did just get him confused with David Dvorak. So my apologies to him as well. Sleeper, real sleeper? I don't know if you can call Dracus Duplessis a sleeper. I know a lot of people aren't familiar with his KSW career, but he is a really... he is a really, really talented middleweight and a fight finisher, just the kind of guy that that the UFC loves. So I don't know if he's going to be a world champion. Do I think he's someone who could have like a 10-12 UFC fight career with lots of bonuses and headlining fight nights and just generally being a favorite of the matchmakers and Dana White? Yes. So Dracus Duplessis, who fights Trevin Giles today, first fight on ESPN, the ESPN prelims. Watch out for him, guys, if you have not had a chance to see him fight yet. I was laughing because Al Mack said, don't listen to AK, bet on MMA. That's terrible advice. That is terrible advice.
Close enough to the water, but not Madison?
Oh, goodness. Okay. I will answer this question because, again, sorry, guys. We've had some technical difficulties. Mike is supposed to be here. But, again, this Wi-Fi is just completely crazy. And he was telling me before the show about how big an underdog Ryan Hall is. So Mixed Perfection in the comments wants to know, who do you think? Why do you think Ryan Hall is an underdog? Okay, I will give the realistic answer here. So the realistic answer is Topuria is a legitimate undefeated featherweight prospect. He's quite a bit younger than Ryan Hall. I'm looking here now, 12 years younger. That's a lot. That's a lot in real life. That's a lot in fight years. I know people say, well, Ryan Hall only has whatever, 9 fights, and it's, you know, but he's the training. He's been training for a long time, grappling experience, of course. There's a lot of wear and tear on Ryan Hall. I'm seeing here on Tapology, so excuse me if I'm missing like the really, really big odds. Topuria is a -250 favorite. So that's over 2-1. It's considerable. When Mike was telling me before the show, I thought he meant like 3-1 or 4-1. -250 is pretty heavy though. That is still pretty big odds for Topuria. Again, Topuria is so well-rounded. He seems like he'd be very difficult to force onto the ground, even with a specialist like Ryan Hall. So that's going to be an issue. Ryan Hall's stand-up can be very mystifying. That might be the nice way to put it. If you guys watch like the Gray Maynard fight, you'd certainly call it an orthodox approach to striking. But he wins fights. The guy wins. And obviously, he's my pick. I think Ryan Hall is unique. One of the most can't-miss fighters today. He just has such a specialized skill set. It's just the kind of thing we don't see as much in MMA anymore. And I'm not saying one-dimensional. I'm saying a specialist. He is a specialist, and he is so damn good at what he does. Topuria has been saying in the lead-up to the fight, look, I don't care. I'll grapple with him. I'll strike with him. I'm not afraid of his grappling at all. And if I'm a better, that talk scares me. If I'm a better, I hope that, and I'm betting on Topuria, I hope he's just kidding. I hope he tries to keep the fight standing, goes for the knockout. Because let me tell you something. If he goes to the ground with Ryan Hall, you may never see Ilia Topuria fight again. Okay, that is just my... I'm sorry. We have people predicting. This the break says, Ryan going to KO that dude. Wouldn't that be amazing? Wouldn't that be amazing? But yes, to answer the question, to fight solid, really looks like it could be a contender someday. Only 24 years old. Ryan Hall, again, is now known as sort of this injury-prone guy. He rarely fights. He's 36, so there's that view that he's an older guy. Again, he only has 9 MMA fights, so it's understandable. I don't agree with it. I think I don't blame them for favoring Topuria. I think -250 is a little high, but I understand. I understand where it's coming from as well. So don't bet on MMA.
Okay.
Hello, hello.
Can you hear me, AK?
I hear you, Casey. Can everyone hear you?
Was there a Ryan Hall trash talk going on? Because I'll
no, sir.
I would tear every camera down and it's like.
So this Ryan Hall talk, guys, has summoned Casey. I think I'm a big Ryan Hall fan. I don't think I'm as big a Ryan Hall fan as EKC Lydon is. Casey, are you? I assume that everyone can hear you now, correct?
Yeah, I think so.
You love people are tired of hearing my voice.
As soon as I start talking, then I start losing your voice. So I just came here to say that people are underestimating K1's Ryan Hall. The man dropped Darren Elkins twice with kicks. K1 level Ryan Hall. That's all. Good night.
K1 level Ryan Hall. So look, K1 Hall is certainly one. We know 50-50 Hall. We know the master of the 50-50 position. But do you know about K1 Ryan Hall? Because if you don't, you better educate yourself. Scott McCray, did someone forget to tell Topuria that Ryan Hall is the... I think Topuria knows. Again, like I said, it's the odds makers I'm worried about. I guess they think it's another Ryan Hall or something. Jim from Softball is predicting Dragon Punch KO. Hall that scars Topuria's chest for life, so he's gonna give him like a Ryu Dragon Punch and give him a Sagat scar up the chest, which would be pretty sick, and probably is what would take Topuria to the next level. But that would be pretty dope. The kid from Hex says Saitama ready Ryan Hall. So hey, look, this is why, guys. You're wondering why didn't I pick him as my under the radar guy? He ain't under the radar. We're all talking about it. Okay, everyone knows Ryan Hall is fighting on Saturday. Guys, you can keep presenting your questions. I'm going to do a quick recap.
We got Carlos Condit coming up.
Oh, we got Carlos Condit coming up.
Athlete to the scale in the UFC's welterweight division, the former UFC interim champion, the natural born killer, Carlos Condit.
One 71.
171 pounds, the official weight for Carlos Condit.
171 for Carlos Condit. His fight with Max Griffin is now official. Oh, still no music. My bad. I queued that up. I want to give Yana Kunitskaya has responded via Twitter in a weight miss just with a angry swearing face emoji. So again, we still don't know. Oh, actually, we might know. Let me do a quick check here. I'm just juggling a few things. I'm going to just do a quick check, see if we have official word on whether that fight will proceed, Irene Aldana and Yana Kunitskaya. So we don't know yet. And by the way, again, I just want to remind people, if you're seeing that Rafael Dos Anjos weighed in, Casey, I think we might want to add that to the graphic at the bottom somewhere. Rafael Dos Anjos did weigh in, came in successfully 156, and it is official. I do see it on the UFC's website now. RDA is the backup for the UFC 264 main event between Poirier and McGregor. We all kind of knew that that's what's going to happen. But yeah, now we have it. We do have it officially. Tyler David says, I feel like blasting a Hadouken at your opponent will cost you a point. Actually, Tyler David, I don't know if you guys saw this Ultimate Fighter. Me and like all other people are watching. There was a brilliant fight between Ricky Tercios and Dan Races fights with a Hadouken. So if you have a ESPN Plus, guys, go back and just fast forward and watch that fight. It's an amazing fight. So the Ultimate Fighter can still produce some quality fights like that. And Ricky Tercios celebrates with a fireball. Gosh, who else used to shoot a fireball? That guy in the Bellator, but he did it in a fight. Casey or Jose, if you're there and you can chime in, goodness help me. His name Ed something. He's a coach as well. But he threw a fireball in a fight, and his opponent was immediately incinerated. It was pretty crazy. Let's see. We got some. All right, guys. I'm going back to your questions here. Going back to your questions while we wait for Greg Hardy, Michel Pereira, and Jerome Rivera. Carlos Condit did just weigh in, guys. He did just weigh in at 171. So just waiting on three names here. One of them a heavyweight, so it shouldn't be a big issue. Though, as I mentioned earlier, answering your question, it is one of the heavyweights that has actually kind of put in a scare at the on the scale once. Someone's saying, y'all late, Connor already weighed in. Yes, Connor has successfully weighed in, guys, but stick around. You know, again, like I said, we're still waiting for Greg Hardy, Michel Pereira, and Jerome Rivera. let's see. Angela Montgomery wants to know, AK, RDA was the backup for the main. Dustin seems to have wanted this at 170. Connor was said to have staff. How healthy do you think both guys are coming in? I wasn't aware of the staff rumor. But I don't know. Yeah, sorry, Angela. I won't speculate on that. I have not heard anything, any significant health issues about either fighter or from either camp. So my assumption going in is, with MMA, if something's wrong, we'll hear the excuses after. But my assumption going in is both guys are in pretty good shape, other than, of course, maybe looking a little bit drained from having to make 155. But. FC Dub says, thank you for putting the names and weights, everyone. First time I've seen... Wait, don't thank me. Thank Casey for getting that stuff done. He is, again, the best producer in the business. Now he has sound effects when it's a praise for him. Where's the... Can we do an official... Do we have the official sound effect ready, Casey? You can answer in sound effects if you're ready. Okay. Let's do a rundown so we can, guys, you guys deserve to hear the noise. We have, about an hour left. Anyway, I don't see anyone coming up. Casey, I think we need to, I'm looking at the stream. So our main event, Trilogy Bout, Dustin Poirier and Conor McGregor, both fighters using the 1 pound allowance, but successfully making weight at 156. That huge bout is official. Damn, I didn't realize how much I missed it. We have a welterweight contenders bout in the co-main event. Gilbert Burns and Stephen Thompson. Stephen Thompson very likely to become the number one contender, or at least the next to face the winner of Kamaru Usman's next title defense. So he's fighting Gilbert Burns. Both men successfully made weight. 170.5. That fight... Something going on down there. Got some applause. Tai Tuivasa weighed in 263 for a heavyweight bout with Greg Hardy. We're still waiting on Greg Hardy. Irene Aldana missed weight 139.5, 3.5 pounds over the bantamweight limit for her fight with Yana Kunitskaya. Yes, yes. At 134.5. Again, we don't know if that fight's going through. If it does, it will be a catch weight. Aldana probably giving up at least 30% of her purse. So that is not official. But Sean O'Malley, the main card opener, 135.5, and short notice replacement, Chris Moutinho stepping in for Luis Smolka. He weighed in 135. That fight is official. We just saw the natural born killer, Carlos Condit, successfully weigh in. Max Griffin weighed in earlier at 170.5, and Condit came in 171. So that fight is official. Nico Price, 169.5 for his welterweight bout with Michelle Pereira, who we are still waiting on. Ryan Hall and Ilia Topuria both successfully weighed in. Hall, 145. Topuria, 145.5. That fight is official. Drakus Duplessis and Trevin Giles both came in at 185.5 for their middleweight bouts. That fight is official. Flyweight, I would say contenders. They are both ranked in the MMAfighting.com rankings. Go to MMAfighting.com to check those. Jennifer Maya at 125.5. Jessica Ai at 125.5. That flyweight bout is official. And then Omari Akhmedov coming in 185.5 to face Brad Tavares, who weighed in successfully at 184.5. That fight is official. Zalgas Zumagulov, 125.5 for his flyweight bout with Jerome Rivera, who we are still waiting on. He's going to make his fourth UFC appearance, but just a second at 125 pounds. And then we have one more fight that we can get ready for. Alan Abadovsky at 186 and Hu Yazong at 185.5 at middleweight, successfully making weight. That fight is official. Brilliant. That felt so good. That felt so good, I guess. Oh. Guys, we are cruising. We are cruising right now. Thank you, everyone who's just tuned in. Thank you, everyone who's been sticking around. What would a Conor McGregor fight week be without some sort of craziness? And again, we love that you guys are tuning in, watching, commenting, asking questions. FC Dubs, what preliminary fight are you looking forward to? Obviously, Ryan Hall and Ilia Topuria. And as I said, sort of on one of the shows earlier this week, Michelle Pajeda and Nico Price. That is a brilliant piece of matchmaking because Nico Price, madman. Michelle Pajeda, madman. Michelle Pajeda has become somewhat more mature and controlled, and he's winning fights. He's on his first two-fight win streak in the UFC, so good for him. I'm glad. If he wants to fight smarter, safer, he's a great striker. I'm all for it. But when you put him in there with someone like Nico Price, something crazy is probably going to happen. So I can't predict it. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it'll turn out to be a snoozer. Maybe we got like a Lewis and Ganu situation where one guy is fighting really smart and the other guy's trying to make something happen that's just not there. But I am the Prince of Positivity. I am optimistic, and I'm waiting to I'm very, very much looking forward to that one. Nobody wants to know, is the Aldana fight still on? We don't know. Let me do a quick check. Let me do you guys a quick check here. Did miss weight by quite a bit. I would imagine they would want to keep this on. Yes, we don't know yet. Okay, no, we do not have an update on that. And keep in mind also, fingers crossed, we have had situations in the past. I'm not saying that's what's going to happen here. We have had situations in the past where the fighters do agree to do a catch weight, but you know, if someone misses weight, sometimes there's reasons around it. There might be an illness. It just might have been a super tough cut and just takes a lot out of them. And then on the Saturday, the day of the fight, you kind of hear maybe a fighter didn't pass their. So as Jose Youngs would say, if you were on right now, he is on site, but if you were on the stream right now, he would say, until we see these two people step into the cage, we don't know. As of now, we really don't know, because they have to negotiate some sort of purse penalty if Kunitskaya wants to take the fight at all.
Little things like I told her from Hartford the other day, she'd be on Coach Bus, and it was fucking school bus. You know, it's little things that challenge you when you're not, you know, yeah. She gets bars.
Hello, help.
All right, next fighter to the scale, making his second pay-per-view appearance here tomorrow night on the main card at UFC 264 in the heavyweight division, the Prince of War, Greg Hardy.
Here is Greg Hardy coming up.
The official weight for Greg Hardy.
264.5 for Greg Hardy. Well, Casey, that means Mr. Greg Hardy's fight with Tai Tuivasa is now official. Are now, guys, just waiting on Michel Pajeda and Jerome Rivera. So, just two fighters left. Yes, yes, Casey, can you hear me?
Both gentlemen may wait in the heavyweight fight.
I know, I said it. I said I don't think you heard, or maybe I didn't. I think maybe I broke up. Yes, that's right. Greg Hardy has successfully made weight, as has Tai Tuivasa at 263 pounds. So that heavyweight main card bout is official. Apologies, guys. Apologies for the delay in the music. We've got, again, some technical difficulties here. Sometimes I think I'm coming through. Sometimes I'm not. But again, our boy's holding it down. Our boy's holding it down on site. It's been, guys, tune in. We'll have a preview show later today. If you want to know more, kind of how the experience has been on site in Las Vegas, Conor McGregor fight week, trilogy bout fight week. The stars are out. You know, again, we're sort of in this still in this COVID-19 era, I think it's fair to say. But at the same time, a lot of things are pretty much opening up, right? Especially, you know, in places like Las Vegas. So it's been a very different experience than it has been for Jose, who also went to so many of the UFC Apex shows. But that was just really, again, you're pretty much in a bubble, and you're almost really not able to do anything. So we can hear a little bit later how, if at all, if anything even different. So then to the preview show later today, should feature all your favorite MMA fighting personalities. Ricardo Cornejo is asking, is Shaheen going to be in any video this week? I don't know. I don't want to speak for him. I don't know. It'd be great if he could, but again, we've all got our own responsibilities. He's written some incredible stories in the lead up to this event. So guys, please again, head over to MMAfighting.com check out his story about Dustin Poirier's The Good Fight Foundation. A lot of positive vibes in there, some testimonials from some of the people that Dustin Poirier's charity has helped. So, you know, if you guys feel like, you know, donating that sort of thing too, definitely link into it. It's The Good Fight Foundation, Dustin Poirier. Check out Sean's story. And he also just had a nice interview with his old pal, Carlos Condit, where Condit, the lifer, the MMA lifer, looks back on some of his favorite moments in his career. That story, I believe, just went up today. So MMAfighting.com, guys, today or yesterday. Either way, it's live at MMAfighting.com. Shaheen.
We got AK back. Can I hear your sweet voice, AK?
Yes. All right, I wonder if you guys can hear me. Sorry, guys, again, phone in and out, guys, so please bear with us. But I did want to just say again, go to MMAfighting.com, check out Sean Alshadi's stories on Dustin Poirier's The Good Fight Foundation and his interview with Carlos Condit going over some of the Natural Born Killer's favorite MMA memories. Can't miss this stuff, guys. Sean is back in full force, wearing just these beautiful features. MMAfighting.com. And also, like, you guys probably missed this. I said, please put a sun emoji or shout out Go Suns in the, unless you're from Milwaukee, then I understand why you may not want to do that, or you're an LA Clippers fan or any other team that the Phoenix Suns beat. But if you're impartial and you just want to support Sean, Go Suns. They're up 2-0 in the NBA Finals. It'll change the man's life. I don't know what's going to happen. I will say the other reason, guys, you might not want to root for Sean is I don't know what's going to happen to him if the Phoenix Suns win the NBA title. I believe our Jose Youngs is also a fan, of course, of the Phoenix Suns. So show your support for him as well. There you go. Thank you, AlBF. There's a sun emoji. But I don't know what's going to happen to these guys if the Phoenix Suns win the NBA title, because they might just wild out and we may never see them again. They may just want to go out on top. But hopefully they will show up for work the next day should the Phoenix Suns win the NBA title. Chrissy J, I'm loud. I know I'm super loud. I have to make sure I'm being heard because, again, we're having some sort of connection issues. So I might be overdoing it a little bit. I apologize. RIP headphones. Oh, it's my face. There we get in there. Okay. So just hitting on two people, Michelle Pereira, Domolidor, and Jerome Rivera coming in for our flyweight fight with Zalgas Zumagulov. Let me ask you guys a question. What did you guys think of, you guys can respond in the chat, what do you guys think of the Sean O'Malley matchmaking? It's been quite a point of controversy amongst us, so it has been amongst fans, and he needed a last-minute replacement because his originally scheduled opponent, Luis Smolka, was forced to withdraw. So some names stepped up, Tim Elliott, Ray Borg, Ricky Simone, perhaps first and foremost, Merab Dvalishvili, said he's in Las Vegas, give me the fight. And the UFC ends up bringing in a newcomer, signing CES or CFFC. Either way, East Coast regional scene veteran, Chris Moutinho, to take the fight, which I think is fine. I thought it was normal. You're trying to build up Sean O'Malley. I don't know why you want to get cute with the matchmaking and bring in another name on short, like another, you know, up-and-coming bantamweight on short notice. But at the same time, I understand you're bringing in a guy who's supposed to be a star already to fight someone that no one's ever heard of. So what does that say about how they're building him up? So yeah, let me see your comments here, guys. Noah's Ghost says Harlem Globetrotters all the way, which I think is a basketball reference, but also could have answered my question. I don't know if you're saying they're bringing in Chris Moutinho to be the Washington Generals, but it certainly could be the case. F, just the letter F. Nothing to gain, everything to lose. Nick Duroff says he's the UFC version of Michael Page. I do see that a lot. I think they've given him Casey, how are we doing? Oh, I think we're back. Hey guys, apologies for that. Apologies, and I understand we had a bit of a, we were on a bit of a, again, some stream issues here. So apology for that. Yeah, Chrissy J, can't talk about O'Malley. Look, talked about O'Malley. Look what happened. The UFC brought it down. They heard me talking about it. Ricky Simone, I think, would have been a really good choice. Just a comment from Curtis Street saying Ray Borg and Tim Elliott were never offered. Yeah, that sounds about right. Ray Borg and Tim Elliott kind of chimed in on social media. Both guys normally flyweights, but obviously willing to go fight at 135 on short notice. But those didn't seem like realistic options. Ray Borg, not even currently with the UFC. He actually just picked up a win overseas. So he's back in the win column, but not with the UFC. Perhaps he saw this as his chance to come back in. But Escalmaza, I know you said before about the Diaz brothers. I can't really say for sure. Do I think they negotiated the replacement for O'Malley? I'm sure that's maybe how they heard of Moutinho, maybe through some connections. But I can't imagine the Diaz brothers actively pulling strings. I think they have their own sort of negotiations with the UFC, like that they have to just are constantly battling over. So hey, if they have time to sort of get their teammates in there, props to them. I don't think that's how it went down. Noah's Ghost just says Merab. Just wanted to see. Let's make it happen. Just get Merab in there with them. Let's put prospect. Well, I should say prospect. Let's get rising contender versus rising contender. Let's have him throw down. I think they do fight someday. Haroon Kid. Haroon, you made the same mistake Mike and I did once on an episode of On to the Next One, by the way, our matchmaking podcast, which you can watch. You can listen to every Sunday and Monday wherever good podcasts are found. Haroon Kid wants to know, can you imagine O'Malley and Kyler Phillips? That would be a sweet, sweet fight. I thought so too. Unfortunately, I believe O'Malley and Kyler are friends and do train together. I'm not saying it could never happen. I do believe they do train together though quite a bit at this point in their careers. I don't think it's going to happen. Who knows down the road, they move to different teams. They're both contenders and they have to, but I don't think that's happening anytime soon. It would be a really, really amazing fight. Let me just check. We might have an update. Someone's commenting. We might have an update on Aldana and Kunitskaya. Let me see what people are saying. Do we have an update from the... Okay. I am seeing reported, yes, per the UFC. It will be a 30% fine.
UFC Fight Pass at UFC 264 in the flyweight division, Jerome Rivera.
Here comes Jerome Rivera. As I was saying, Irina Aldana, she missed weight by 3.5 pounds. She will forfeit 30% of her purse, and her bout with Yana Kunitskaya will proceed at a catch weight. So big, big miss there. Costly miss.
And a half. The official weight for Jerome Rivera.
Let's go, baby. 125 and a half for Jerome Rivera. His opponent, August Zumagulov, made 125.5 earlier. And guess what? That flyweight fight, guys. That's official. That flyweight fight, guys. That's official. Well, guys, I tried. They're dealing with a lot of Casey and Jose with a lot of, again, they're running around down there, two-man crew running around taking care of business. So we'll get you the music later. Do not worry. You will hear that sweet, sweet official music. Hopefully two more times, because again, we are still waiting on Michel Pereira, who has missed welterweight in the UFC. He did miss weight for his fight with Tristan Connolly, if I'm not mistaken, in what turned out to be a crazy upset. When an absolutely massive Pereira was outworked, wrestled by a good old Canadian, Tristan Connolly. So I think he learned a lot from that fight. And I would hope we don't see that again. But he's a big guy.
To weigh in this morning in the UFC's welterweight division, competing
here we go.
On ESPN tomorrow, Michel Pereira. The official weight for Michel Pereira.
170.5 for Michel Pereira. Jesus. Sorry, guys, that caught me off guard. But I expect the real theatrics. He's done some acrobatics at the actual ceremonial weigh-in, so definitely tune into those later, guys. We will have video of ceremonial later today. Michel Pereira, by the way, how dare I question and mention his previous weight miss. He made at 170.5. So his fight with Nico Price, one of our favorites to look out for, is official. Guys, just play the, you know, you hear the, and hear the music. It's fine. So I'll do a quick truck kick.
You gotta wait.
I want to catch you off guard. It's not.
You gotta wait till the weight is on the screen. It's not official, man. Come on, AK.
Well, can I get one for Zaga Zumagulov and Jerome Rivera as well?
And why am I gonna give you one? Because
it was official like 10 minutes ago. Well-oiled machine, guys, here at MMAfighting.com headquarters. Well-oiled machine,
that's
as
my
you
nickname.
Can see. No comments. No comment. Don't get us demonetized. Okay, guys, I'll do a quick rundown of the win. Casey, what stare downs at the top of the hour, or were they going to do it as soon as they clear off the stage?
This is not a UFC Apex Fight Night card, man.
Oh, I'm silly. I just well-oiled machine here. I'm sorry. I just literally said what time? I'm sorry.
This
what
is
time
UFC
are the ceremony?
The card that was built what around is Ryan Hall. Get that straight.
Yes. According to John Anik, it was built around both Dustin Poirier and Conor McGregor. I don't
think
he built
Ryan
around.
Hall. And Ryan Hall.
And also Ryan Hall. And Michelle Pereira. Casey, what time are these ceremonial weigh-ins? Local time, I will translate for
4 p.m.
Pacific. 4 p.m. Pacific. So, guys, that will be 4 p.m. Pacific time, 7 p.m. Eastern time, ceremonial weigh-ins. That's when we'll see, again, another face-off between Dustin Poirier and Conor McGregor. We'll see some, again, we'll see some craziness, I think, from Michelle Pereira. We'll just see Ryan Hall just being Ryan Hall. What else needs to be said? So that'll be later today. So yes, guys, I think we're going to, Casey, I assume we're just going to log off, tune off for now.
Yeah.
Oh, after I read the results, I just don't want to, I just want to let people, please stick around. We're going to read the results here. From the top, everyone, UFC 264, your main card, main event, trilogy bout, lightweight, Dustin Poirier and Conor McGregor, both coming in at 156 pounds, successfully making weight. Then in the co-main event, we have welterweight contenders Gilbert Burns and Stephen Thompson, both coming in 170.5. Heavyweight action, Tai Tuivasa at 263, Greg Hardy at 264. We have our lone miss of the 26 fighters competing on Saturday, Irene Aldana. There it is. Irene Aldana coming in 139.5, missing bantamweight by 3.5 pounds. For her fight with Yana Kunitskaya, who came in 134.5. That will proceed at a catch weight. Aldana will forfeit 30% of her purse. And leading off the main card, bantamweight bout, Sean O'Malley and short notice replacement, Chris Moutinho. O'Malley, 135.5. Moutinho at 135. ESPN featured prelim welterweights Max Griffin and Carlos Condit. Max Griffin, 170.5. The natural born killer, 171. Nico Price came in 169.5 for his welterweight bout with Michelle Pereira, our last man to weigh in, came in successfully 170.5. Very cool welterweight clash between the GOAT Ryan Hall at 145 and Ilia Topuria 145.5, unbeaten 10-0 in pro MMA competition. Dricus du Plessis 185.5 for his middleweight bout with Trevin Giles, who also came in 185.5. Flyweights jockeying for position, and that's what I think is a solid, solid division. Jennifer Maya, 125.5. Jessica I, 125.5. Omari Akhmedov, 185.5 for this middleweight bout on the prelims with Brad Tavares, who came in 184.5. This will be Brad Tavares' 20th UFC appearance when he makes the walk on Saturday night. Zaga Zumagulov, 125.5, and Jerome Rivera at 125.5. Their flyweight bout is official. And then leading off the entire show, we have Alan Amadovsky, 186, and Hu Yaozong at 185.5 for a middleweight bout. So, thank you guys for joining us. Thank you for putting up with all of our technical difficulties. Thank you for your amazing questions and comments, and just for just being you. Excuse me. And just being you. Ceremonial weigh-ins later today, 4 p.m. Pacific time, 7 p.m. Eastern time. We will have a preview show later today. We'll have predictions tomorrow morning. We'll have pre-fight Q&A, probably 45 minutes for Saturday's card, maybe longer. It's a big show. We'll be there at least 45 minutes before. So tune in for live Q&A tomorrow before the show, which starts at 6 p.m. Eastern time. 6 p.m., 6:30 p.m. Check your local listings. Either way, we'll be on. We'll let you know. Keep your eye on MMA Fighting, the Twitter, the YouTube, MMAfighting.com, guys. Read Sean's features. Read everyone's stories. And we are signing off for Jose Youngs, EKC Line on site, and myself here, Alexander Cayley. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching.